This man, one of the most talked about celebrities in the world, is the first of two mystery guests to challenge the panel tonight on What's My Line? America's total performance cars for 66, Ford, Fairlane, Falcon, Mustang, and Thunderbird. And now let's all play What's My Line? And now from New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in papers coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
And on my left, the man who brilliantly acts as Arlene France's husband 8 times a week, Mr. Ralph Meeker.
And on my left, my lovely onstage wife, Arlene Francis.
Hello, honey.
Thank you.
And now the man who brilliantly plays my offstage husband, Martin Gable.
Now a man who has just run on foot from a dinner that he was addressing at the Arthritis Foundation in honor of General Kenny, who was commanding general of the 5th Air Force under General MacArthur, Mr. John Daly. True, I may be breathless now, but hang on, because we're playing tricks tonight to celebrate the happy occasion that has Mr. and Mrs. Daly with us, and Mr. and Mrs. Gable with us, all at the same time.
And you can be our child, Dorothy.
And Dorothy can be our child. We have two mystery guests tonight, so get your blindfolds on immediately, if you will, panel, because this will give you some idea of the dimensions of the tricks that are to be played on you tonight. Needless to say, we'll have some interesting occupations also to share with you a little later on, but right now we will start things off. The two famous mystery guests before the panel. Let's meet the first of our mystery guests. If those blindfolds are all in place, are they, panel?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Good.
Sir.
Then will the first mystery guest enter and sign in, please? Of our mystery guests, we go to a different form of questioning, one question at a time in turn, moving clockwise, and I think we'll begin everything with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Are you in show business?
Yes.
Mr. Meeker?
Are you in films?
Yes.
Miss Francis?
It's very hard to tell from that yes whether you're male or female, but you know, don't you? Are you in the New York area appearing at the present time? In something?
No.
That's one down and 9 to go. Actually, I'm going to qualify that, if I may, and say that since you said the New York area and considering all the activities of our guest, we will admit that there is, in a sense, an appearance at this time, if it's all right with you. Okay, Mr. Gable?
Are you male?
Yes.
Ms. Kilgallen?
Are you about to open in a play on Broadway in the very near future?
No.
One down and 9 to go, Mr. Meeker.
Have I ever worked with you?
No.
Chewed out a date to go, Miss Francis?
I think wishes he had, Ralphie. Are you working on a picture at the present time?
Yes.
Mr. Gable,
is the picture being shot in New York?
Yes.
Miss Kilgallen?
Oh, good night. Here goes my question again.
All I know is Sean Connery.
No. You never lost your address book in a helicopter over the Greek islands, did you?
No.
3-7 to go, Mr. Meeker.
I'll pass.
Miss Francis?
Is the picture you are making in New York the picture with Sean Connery?
Yes.
Mr. Gale? Were you ever James Bond 007? Sean Connery, and actually, you see, that was the problem, because Mr. Connery is making A Fine Madness. It's being shot here in New York right now, whereas The Hill, a picture, is going to open this week, hasn't opened yet.
Yes.
And yet some of the earlier films that he's made, needless Doc to Know with Russia from Love and Mr. Goldfinger and all those, or Goldfinger, I guess, not Mr. These, I know, are showing somewhere in the New York area, so I had to beg the answer. I hope you don't mind. The Hill, I know, is something that you're much more interested in terms of the character of the play than anything you've done some time.
That's, it's such a change, you know, after the initial one on the first of the Bond films. It's, from then on in, you've just got to have the stamina of a rugby player. But the interest of something like The Hill is the actual character.
Did it open as a play in London originally?
No, it was a novel, which the producer, Kenny Hyman, bought from Ray Rigby. And then he got in touch with Sidney Lumet, and then the whole thing started moving, and we did it in Spain.
It's set in a disciplinary army camp in Africa during the war.
That's right, the British Army.
Mm.
Somewhat anti-British, so we got no cooperation from the British Army.
Somewhat anti-British.
Well, it's not really, it's anti-establishment.
Anti-establishment. Well, that...
But isn't the present picture of Fine Madness a departure from 007 entirely?
Yes. No more than the Hill. You know, they're all sort of slightly different.
Well, I would rather imagine, in spite of all of the kudos that you have properly earned and all of the fame and to some degree fortune that has come from the Bond pictures, it must be good fun to be getting away from that role once in a while and doing other things.
Very good. Thanks.
Well, we wish, it's nice to have you as a visitor in New York, sir.
Thank you.
And we thank you muchly for coming to What's My Line when you're visiting.
It's my
good
pleasure.
To have you with us.
Thank you very much.
Contestant for you in just a moment after this word. It's our next contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please?
Sue Logan, right? Is it Miss or Mrs. Loglin?
Miss.
Miss Loglin. And, you've come to New York to visit us. That's very nice. May I present the panel? And now, would you join me over here? And if it's in the panel's mind now to ask where you're from, we might just as well tell them we're not going to let them know for the moment, for fear that it might tell them some things they have no business to know at this particular moment in time. We will, however, let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, we will tell you that Miss Logan is salaried and deals in a service, but we will agree that in a manner of speaking, there's also a rather vital part played by what we might call a product. And with all of that help, let's start things going with Martin Gable.
Thank you, John. Miss Logan, if I knew where you were from, would it tend to give me a clue as to what you do?
Yes, it could.
Are you, however remotely, connected with something that is in the national interest?
Yes.
Is it in the southern part of the United States?
No.
One down and nine to go, Miss Kilgallen. And I must tell you, quite honestly, Martin, that we took the phrase national interest there to have a very broad context.
Gotcha.
Miss Kilgallen.
Miss Loveland, do you spend much time in Washington, D.C.?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Mr. Meeker.
This product that is connected with your service, would this be used by men and women?
Yes, it could.
Could I hold it in my hand?
You might.
Would this be found in the home?
Yes, it could be.
There'd be circumstances under which we would agree that it might reside for a period in the home, but this is not to suggest to you that it rests there solely and for the exclusion of any other place.
Then it is not limited to the home.
Right.
Would this product be mineral?
No.
That makes it three down and seven to go, Miss Francis.
May I rule out that your business has anything to do with Italy at
yes,
the moment?
You may.
Is the product now, or has it ever been alive?
No.
Four down and six to go, Mr. Gable.
Has it anything to do, at this moment at least, with an event that is about to take place
but
here?
That's Italy.
I said nothing about Italy. I've got my own events, you know, like the World Series.
When you say here, you mean in this country?
Yes, I do, John.
Yes.
I noticed you gave me a double swing there. Is there anything to do with athletics in regard to what you do?
Yes, it does.
Has it anything to do with a great athletic event that's about to start this coming week?
Yes.
Is it a sport, is it baseball?
Yes, it is.
Have you something to do with the World Series coming up?
Yes.
Do you have anything to do with the issuance of tickets for the World Series?
Very good. And to celebrate your perspicacity, I'm going to throw all the cards over. You got it?
Well, right. I actually owe it to Arlene, who localized it. She thought it was something to do with Pope Paul's visit tomorrow. Mm-hmm. And in self-defense, I left on the World Series.
Well,
I don't want to take too much credit.
It's your event.
I think we should announce, but I don't think it's necessary, that Miss Logan comes from Minneapolis, Minnesota. By the way, you go to the University of Minnesota, don't
That's
you?
Right. Yeah.
What are you doing in Minnesota? What are you specializing?
Psychology.
And what about World Series tickets? You brought some for all of us, haven't you?
Oh, naturally.
You have? You think you'll get out of the theater after having said that tonight without making delivery?
No, but I might not have a job.
You might not have a job. What year are you in at the university?
Junior.
Oh, wonderful. And do you do ticket work in the summer during the baseball season every summer? And this year it runs a little bit longer. And you're very happy about it.
Very happy.
Well, I was up in your part of the country, and I know what a thrill it is to the whole state to have the World Series played there. So congratulations to you and all of your fellow Minnesotans. And thanks very much for being our guest. Nice to have you. Miss Logan, this, Martin, but I think it'll interest you. I read a Minnesota paper this week several times, mostly because we don't have many papers in New York anymore. But if I remember the piece I read, I think they returned something in excess of $2,600,000 worth of checks for people who had sent in asking for tickets for the World Series. $2 million.
Incredible.
So it's the national pageant. Now the second special feature of our program tonight, the appearance of a mystery challenger for which the panel must once again blindfold itself. Are all blindfolds in place, panel?
Yes.
Yes.
Good. Will you enter, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? panel. A different form of questioning, remember. One question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise, and we'll begin with Mrs. Daly.
Thank you, John. Are you part of the entertainment world?
Oui, Mr. Gable.
Are you about to open in a new play on Broadway?
May we? Miss Kilgallen?
Are you Henry Fonda?
Yeah. Ah!
I was thinking of you the first time around.
I was going to ask you if I ever worked with you.
Yeah, you didn't get a chance.
I guess if anybody in the New York area doesn't know that you're opening at the Roscoe Theater on Wednesday, in generation, there's something wrong with us. But, yeah. You know, Henry said right after you nailed it, I said two. Just two questions. So it nearly was.
We were waiting for you, Henry.
I knew.
But this is more than a new play generation, is it not? The research indicates that this is an anniversary, too, for you.
I haven't read the research. Tell me, John.
Well, no, I'm told, and if I'm wrong, knock me down, that this is your 30th anniversary in pictures and staged. 1934,
right? It was my 30th anniversary in movies. I made my 60th picture about 2 months ago. But I was in the theater 10 years before I ever made a movie, so it's my 40th anniversary.
The 40th anniversary.
Well, Henry, didn't you ever go to school?
Yeah, that was after school, too.
That was after school, too.
Wasn't Ralph Meeker and Mr. Roberts?
Original. He is my,
I was his understudy. And he never missed a show.
I knew a girl in Frisco wore flowers in her hair instead of hats. Never wore a hat. That was his line.
That's right. I'm glad you didn't do it then.
We're taking up too much time. You see that man holding things?
No, you're not taking up too much time. Don't worry about that. Happily, that's a matter in my hands. But taking time into account with a generation coming up, and you're making pictures almost faster now than you did 20 years ago or 25 years ago. It's nice of you to find enough time to come and see us.
This is my home. I live in New York, and I love the theater. I always said that, and I'm always glad to find one to bring you back.
We will hope that, Henry, that we'll find some more to bring you back, and that you'll come and visit us when you
do. Thank you,
John. Nice to have you with us. You've done very well so far tonight, panel, and I'll offer congratulations. We'll have another contestant after this word. I'll be the final contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? Al LeBeau, right?
All right, Mr. LeBeau, where are you from?
From Belmore, Long Island.
Belmore, Long Island. Nice to have you with us. May I present the panel? Now, if you'll join me over here, Mr. LeBeau, we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. All right. Panel, we can tell you that Mr. LeBeau is salaried and that he deals in a product, which has, in a sense, a service connected with it.
Who are you starting with?
And we'll start with Ralph Meeker. Mr. Daly.
Your product, Mr. LeBeau, would this be used by both men and women?
Yes.
I see.
Yeah, we would have to agree that in its use, its benefit would be derived to both men and women.
There's a little mystery about that, though, I heard. Could I hold this product in my hand?
No.
No. That's one down and nine to go, Miss Fred.
Mr. LeBeau, you have a marvelous, sunny, outdoorsy expression. Is the product a product that might be found out of doors?
Yes.
When you are working with this product or using it in whatever way you do, do you work with your hands?
Yes.
Is the product anything I could possibly hold in my hand?
No.
No.
Two down and eight to go, Mr. Gable.
Do you ever do any of your work on water, Mr. LeBeau?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Does this product and your service move around a bit while you're working on it?
No.
That makes it four down and six to go, Mr. Meeker.
Would this product be mineral?
No. No.
Five down and five to go, Miss Francis.
Vegetable?
No.
That's small conference.
I'm never too sure what's vegetable myself. I can understand.
Well, tomato, apple.
We've had a very serious consultation here. And contemplating that the question was asked in the context that everything is animal, vegetable, or mineral, and you asked the question, is this vegetable? And having considered the question, we say yes.
Oh, I thought you were going to say no. Is the product a heavy product?
Yes.
Is it found usually on the ground rather than in the air?
Yes.
Well, can it go from the ground up?
Yes.
Is the product, does it have any wood in it?
Yes.
That's vegetable, isn't it, John?
Yeah. Yes, nothing like that. A little steak and some, you know, boiled wood is great.
Do you have anything whatsoever to do with the tree? Joyce Kilmer's trees?
No.
Trees you have nothing to do with?
No, I don't think we can go that far.
It's just that the wood comes from the
trees, you were speaking of that. The wood comes from the tree. That's very good.
Good.
I want to congratulate you, Mr. Gabe. Do you work for a profit-making organization?
Yes.
When you say this product goes from the ground up, does it ever leave the ground?
No.
Seven down and three to go, Miss Kilgallen.
But you told me, did you not, Mr. LeBone, that you don't move about?
You phrased the question that the product and the work moved about, and we agreed that the product didn't move about, so therefore we gave you no answer earlier.
I know, I got a no. I didn't know why. I wanted to make sure. But Mr. LeBone must move around a little bit, doesn't he?
Oh, yes, we agreed to that. We only gave you the no because you specified also whether the product moved.
You didn't tell me that then.
At the time, I didn't feel I ought to.
No. All right, so now we've got something wooden that doesn't go up, or that does go up.
It goes
off
up,
the
but
ground,
doesn't leave the
but
ground.
But doesn't leave the ground.
You want to have
so
a
so it is merely something that goes from smaller to taller, would you say?
From smaller to taller. That
lower
gives me a little
taller.
Bit of trouble, so I'll flip all the
oh,
cards over.
Make
yes.
A
guess.
Is there anything to do with a telephone pole?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
Mr. LeBone inspects telephone poles. They have to be inspected every 5 years, and he goes up and he hits it. You change it if I'm wrong. You hit the pole and you take a coring out, and he looks at it and inspects it to see whether it needs to be replaced because it's gotten sick or chilled blades or something like that.
That's what's the matter with most of my connections,
yeah,
Mr. LeBone.
And he has only 15,000 poles in his country. Mr. LeBone, thanks very much. Nice to have you with us on What's My Life. Used up all the time with the panel's permission, I will say the good nights, and if we could get to Bennett Cerf, who's in Spain, but will be back this week, we'd say good night to Bennett, too, but he isn't here, so instead of that, for all of us, I will say good night to you, and thanks for being with us on What's My Line.
What's My Line is a CBS Television Network production in association with Mark Goodson and Bill Cotton. This is Johnny Olson speaking.
Get ready to walk down the aisle. The Newlywed Game starring Bob Eubanks is next on Game Show Network.
Yes.
Miss Kilgallen?
Are you about to open in a play on Broadway in the very near future?
No.
One down and nine to go, Mr. Meeker.
Have I ever worked with you?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Miss Francis.
I think wishes he had, Ralphie. Are you working on a picture at the present time?
Yes.
Mr. Gable, is the picture being shot in New York?
Yes.
Miss Kilgallen?
Oh, good night. Here goes my question again.
Yeah, all I know is Sean Connery.
No. You never lost your address book in a helicopter over the Greek islands, did you?
No.
That's 3 down, 7 to go, Mr. Meeker.
I'll pass.
Miss Francis?
Is the picture you are making in New York the picture with Sean Connery?
Yes.
Mr. Gale? Were you ever James Bond 007? Sean Connery, and actually, you see, that was the problem, because Mr. Connery is making A Fine Madness. It's being shot here in New York right now, whereas The Hill, a picture, is going to open this week, hasn't opened yet.
Yes.
And yet some of the earlier films that he's made, needless Doc to Know with Russia from Love and Mr. Goldfinger and all those, or Goldfinger, I guess, not Mr. These, I know, are showing somewhere in the New York area, so I had to beg the answer. I hope you don't mind. The Hill, I know, is something that you're much more interested in terms of the character of the play than anything you've done some time.
That's, it's such a change, you know, after the initial one on the first of the Bond films. It's, from then on in, you've just got to have the stamina of a rugby player. But the interest of something like The Hill is the actual character.
Did it open as a play in London originally?
No, it was a novel, which the producer, Kenny Hyman, bought from Ray Rigby. And then he got in touch with Sidney Lumet, and then the whole thing started moving, and we did it in Spain.
It's set in a disciplinary army camp in Africa during the war.
That's right, British Army.
Mm.
It's somewhat anti-British, so we got no cooperation from the British Army.
Somewhat anti-British.
Well, it's not really, it's anti-establishment.
Anti-establishment, well, that...
But isn't the present picture of Fine Madness a departure from 007 entirely?
Yes. No more than The Hill. You know, they're all sort of slightly different.
Well, I would rather imagine, in spite of all of the kudos that you have properly earned and all of the fame and to some degree fortune that has come from the Bond pictures, it must be good fun to be getting away from that role once in a while and doing other things.
Very good. Thank
well, we wish... It's nice to have you as a visitor in New York, sir.
Thank you.
And we thank you muchly for coming to What's My Line when you're visiting.
It's my
pleasure. Good to have you with us.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Contestant for you in just a moment after this word. It's our next contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? Mrs. Loglin.
Yes.
Miss Loglin. And, you come to New York to visit us. That's very nice. May I present the panel? And now, would you join me over here?
This man, one of the most talked about celebrities in the world, is the first of two mystery guests to challenge the panel tonight on What's My Line?
America's total performance cars for 66. Ford, Fairlane, Falcon, Mustang, and Thunderbird. play What's My Line? And now, from New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in papers coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
On my left, the man who brilliantly acts as Arlene France's husband 8 times a week, Mr. Ralph Meeker.
And on my left, my lovely onstage wife, Arlene France.
Honey. And now the man who brilliantly plays my offstage husband, Martin Gable.
Now a man who has just run on foot from a dinner that he was addressing at the Arthritis Foundation in honor.
And if it's in the panel's mind now to ask where you're from, we might as well tell them we're not going to let them know for the moment, for fear that it might tell them some things they have no business to know at this particular moment in time. We will, however, let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, we will tell you that Miss Logan is salaried and deals in a service, but we will agree that in a manner of speaking, there's also a rather vital part played by what we might call a product. And with all of that help, let's start things going with Martin Gable.
Thank you, John. Miss Logan, if I knew where you were from, would it tend to give me a clue as to what you do?
Yes, it could.
Are you, however remotely, connected with something that is in the a national interest?
Yes.
Is it in the southern part of the United States?
No.
One down and 9 to go, Miss Kilgallen. And I must tell you quite honestly, Martin, that we took the phrase national interest there to have a very broad context.
Gotcha.
Miss Kilgallen.
Miss Logan, do you spend much time in Washington, D.C.?
No.
2 down and 8 to go, Mr. Meeker.
This product that is connected with your service, would this be used by men and women?
Yes, it could.
Could I hold it in my hand?
You might.
Would this be found in the home?
Yes, it could be.
There'd be circumstances under which we would agree that it might reside for a period in the home, but this is not to suggest to you that it rests there solely and... For the exclusion of any other place.
Then it is not limited to the home.
Right.
Would this product be mineral?
No.
That makes it 3 down and 7 to go, Miss Francis.
May I rule out that your business has anything to do with Italy at
yes,
the moment?
Of General Kenny, who was commanding general of the 5th Air Force under General MacArthur... to John Daly.
And it's true, I may be breathless now, but hang on, because we're playing tricks tonight to celebrate the happy occasion that has Mr. and Mrs. Daly with us, and Mr. and Mrs. Gable with us, all at the same time.
And you can be our child, Arthur.
And Arthur can be our child. We have 2 mystery guests tonight, so get your blindfolds on immediately, if you will, panel, because this will give you some idea of the dimensions of the tricks that are to be played on you tonight. Needless to say, we'll have some interesting occupations also to share with you a little later on, but right now we will start things off, the 2 famous mystery guests before the panel. Let's meet the first of our mystery guests. If those blindfolds are all in place, are they, panel?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Good, then will the first mystery guest enter and sign in, please?
Thank you.
All right. Panel, as you know, in the case of our mystery guests, we go to a different form of questioning, one question at a time in turn, moving clockwise, and I think we'll begin everything with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Are you in show business?
Yes.
Mr. Meeker?
Are you in films?
Yes.
Miss Francis?
It's very hard to tell from that yes whether you're male or female, but you know, don't you? Are you in the New York area appearing at the present time? In something?
No.
That's one down and nine to go. Actually, I'm going to qualify that, if I may, and say that since you said the New York area and considering all the activities of our guest, we will admit that there is, in a sense, an appearance at this time, if it's all right with you. Okay, Mr. Gable?
Are you male?